Hello dear students, welcome to the course of Engineering Thermodynamics. Myself Mihir Mistry, Assistant Professor from Mechanical Department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. So today we are going to continue our session on entropy chapter, and in particular we are going to discuss about principle of increase of entropy. So here let us understand the funda. For any process that is having infinitesimal small change, you can write that ds will be greater than equal to dq by t. We know that when greater than equal to sign is written, then there might be possibility of reversible as well as irreversible process, right? That is generalized statement or generalized mathematical equation. Now if isolated system is considered, meaning of isolated system is very well aware to you, that is the heat transfer as well as mass transfer will be zero. So here if isolated system is considered, then heat transfer will be equivalent to zero. So dq will be equivalent to zero. So if you will substitute that value in the ds greater than equal to dq by t, then your ds will be greater than equal to zero. Now we know that if equal to sign is there, that means if ds is equivalent to zero, that means for reversible isolated process the entropy will remain constant, because ds is equal to zero, that means change in entropy is equal to zero, that means your entropy will remain constant. So that means if you have reversible system or reversible processes, for that if you have an isolated system, then the entropy change for that particular process or for that particular system will be constant, or entropy change will be zero, right? Example is simple universe, right? Okay, now if the process or system is having the value of ds greater than zero, that means it is irreversible. Okay, that means change in entropy is greater than zero, that shows that the process is irreversible. Okay, so higher the value of ds from the zero, higher will be the irreversibility, and that is the example of universe, that entropy of the universe will always tend to increase, right? So that is what we can derive from this fundamental thing, and that is why it is called as principle of increase of entropy, right? Whether the entropy of the system can be zero if it is reversible, or the system entropy can increase if it is irreversible. The more the system entropy is increasing, the more irreversible the process will become. Okay, so entropy change will indicate, or entropy increase will indicate, will give you the measure of the amount of irreversibility. Okay students, I hope you can appreciate that. Now here we can see that I have shown a simple diagram over here, and in this simple diagram we have a system and surrounding around it. Okay, so now for this system and surrounding, we know that system and surrounding together will constitute universe, right? So for this universe, the entropy change will be greater than or equal to zero. Now entropy change of universe can be segmented into two parts, that is entropy change for system and entropy change for surrounding. So addition of both these entropy changes will be greater than or equal to zero. Now remember students over here, that in case of isolated system, this system which is integrated part will be act as subsystem. Okay, let me explain to you. The meaning is that it might be possible that for system the entropy change is, let us say, negative, but for the surrounding the entropy change will be positive, and that positive value will be higher than the negative value. So your total entropy change of universe will be greater than zero. I am repeating again, what is the practice? The practice is that if system entropy locally is, let us say, decreasing by, let us say, 10 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, so that decrease, that means minus 10 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and the surrounding entropy change might be more than my 10. So let us say, for example, it is plus 15. Okay, so now plus 15 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, that is the entropy change for the surrounding, and minus 10 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, that is the entropy change for the system. So you to, if you to put it together, then you will have plus 5 entropy change for the universe. So that is how entropy change for any system in the universe will work. Okay, so entropy change for any reversible or irreversible processes will be always greater than or equal to zero. It might be possible that locally somewhere the entropy is decreasing, but universally if you will see, then the entropy will always increase. Okay, so that is called as principle of increase of entropy. Now, application of principle of increase of entropy or application of entropy principle. Now, here we have take one case, that is, first case is heat transfer through finite temperature difference. Now, let us consider reservoir A, that is having temperature T1, and reservoir B having temperature T2. And in between these two reservoir, we have connecting tube. Okay, and heat is transferred from T1 to T2. That means the temperature of T1 or reservoir A is higher than temperature of reservoir B. So T1 is greater than T2. Okay, so now here if I want to write down the entropy change for reservoir A, so what will happen? We know that the reservoir A is removing or rejecting Q amount of heat. So delta SA can be written as Q divided by T1. But here negative sign will put because heat is being rejected. So if heat is rejected, that is why negative Q divided by T1. That will be the entropy change for the reservoir at A. Same way for reservoir at B, the entropy change will be how much? So delta SB is equal to Q divided by T2. Right? Here heat is added to the reservoir. That is why it is taken or considered as positive. Right? Now, let us consider that these two reservoirs along with the connecting tube, we are considering a system boundary that is highlighted by a dotted line, right? So that is our system, okay? And let us consider that it is an isolated system. So it is not reacting with the surrounding, okay? So if it is so, then the total entropy will be what? See, entropy is an additive property. That means you can add and subtract two entropies, okay? So that is why the entropy, total entropy change will be S is equal to, or delta S is equal to delta SA plus delta SB. Okay, so delta SA is equal to how much? Minus Q by T1, and delta SB is equal to how much? Plus Q by T2. So in total, if you take LCM, then Q into T1 minus T2 divided by T1, T2. Now here we know that T1 is higher than T2. That is why always delta S of this universe will be greater than zero. And the higher the value of the delta S universe, higher will be the irreversibility. That means if you see here, the delta S universe value is dependent on the value of temperature T1 and T2. Right? So higher the difference between T1 and T2, higher will be the irreversibility, because higher will be the entropy change. Okay. That means if you have finite temperature difference, let us say 100 Kelvin and 30 Kelvin. So for that, let us say irreversibility is something. And if you have more finite temperature difference, let us say 1000 Kelvin and 30 Kelvin, then your irreversibility larger one than the former case. Okay, so I have already told you that measure or amount of irreversibility will depend on the temperature difference between two finite sources. Okay, so here you can appreciate that. Okay, and if T1 is less than T2, then that is not possible. That means if T1 temperature is less than T2 temperature, then heat cannot transfer from reservoir A to reservoir B, because reservoir A temperature is less than reservoir B temperature. So heat cannot transfer. So that means if you do so, T1 is less than T2, then your delta S universe will be less than zero. And that is not possible. That is already discussed. Right? And if it is equal to zero, that means your system, two systems, that is reservoir A and reservoir B, both are in equilibrium. So that means they are having a reversible process. Okay. So that time delta S universe will be equal to zero. Okay. I hope everyone is clear up to this point. Now, that is how you can write down the entropy change for two systems that are connected or in contact with each other. Okay. Here, the entropy change for the connecting tube is not considered, because it is assumed that once the heat transfer has started, so after a certain time, the connecting tube will attain steady flow state. Steady flow state means what? You know, right? That with respect to time, the at particular point, the property will not change. So that is why for the connecting tube, we are not considering the entropy change. So entropy change for that tube is neglected. Okay, now let us move further. Second application is mixing of two fluids or you can also say that adiabatic mixing of through flows, because here you can see that we have a box arrangement over here. In this box arrangement, we have a partition at the center and we are having two gases, right? And the whole box is enclosed in adiabatic enclosure. Okay, so heat cannot transfer. So initially what will happen? Two partitions are there. Left hand side partition is having M1 mass with specific heat of C1 and temperature of T1. Same way the right hand side is having M2 mass with specific heat of C2 at temperature T2. Right? Now, as soon as you will remove the partition, then what will happen? Two fluids will start mixing with each other. Right? Now, here, students, what will happen? The temperature of 2 is less than temperature of 1. That means the left hand side partition is having higher temperature than the right hand side partition. So heat will transfer from left hand side partition to the right hand side partition, or the left hand side system to the right hand side system. So how much heat will transfer? See, what will happen whenever you are, as soon as you will remove the partition, so after certain time, let us say this is 100 Kelvin and this is 30 Kelvin, so both will start mixing, and after certain time the 100 Kelvin will be decreased and this 30 Kelvin will increase, and they both will reach to a mutual intermediate value of, let us say, 55 Kelvin. Okay, so that will be the case. So if the intermediate temperature that these two system will attain after a certain time of the mixing, let us call it as TF, or final temperature. Okay, so that final temperature is called as TF. So obviously this TF will be less than T1 and this TF will be greater than T2. That is why I have written T2 is less than TF is less than T1. Okay, so now whatever amount of heat is transferred from T1 to TF, okay, that same amount of heat is accepted by the gas at T2 temperature. Okay, and see what will happen. Simple. You have left hand side system is having temperature of T1, so that gas will reject the heat and reach to temperature of TF, and your right hand side gas is having temperature of T2, so that will accept the heat and will reach to the temperature of TF, right? So this gas is rejecting the temperature and this gas is increasing the temperature, and both will attain the same value of temperature, that is TF. So whatever amount of heat is rejected by this gas, same amount of heat is absorbed by this gas. So that is why we can write the equation as, you know that the heat transfer is equal to MC delta T, that is why M1 C1 T1 minus TF, that is initial temperature minus final temperature, is equivalent to M2 C2 T2 minus TF, so TF minus T2, that is the temperature attained, high temperature is TF minus T2. Okay, now here if we will make TF as the subject, then what we can write? Simple. If we will make TF as the subject, we can write M1 C1 T1 plus M2 C2 T2 divided by M1 C1 plus M2 C2. Okay, now let us write the entropy change for this kind of system. So for subsystem 1, we can write that entropy change is equal to, you know that at constant temperature heat transfer is taking place, so integration of dQ by T. That is the funda, right? Here dQ is equal to what? MC delta T. So we can simply write M1 C1 dT, right? Now M1 C1 will be constant, take it on the outside of the integration sign. So dT by T integration will give you ln T, and you have the limits of 1 to 2. So your final equation will be delta S is equal to M1 C1 ln T2 by T1. Or here in particular, we can write TF by T1 because the end limits are 1 to F, right? Okay. Now, if we write the temperature here, the temperature is written in the capital D form, right? So make sure that you will take the temperature in Kelvin. So that is why if we take Celsius temperature as, or if we denote Celsius temperature as small d, then small TF plus 273 will give me capital TF, and small T1 plus 273 will give me capital T. That is easily understandable. Right, now the value of this entropy change delta S1 will be negative. Why, sir? Because the value of T1 will be higher than TF, and T1 is in the denominator of the natural log. Right, that is why if you will take the natural log having the higher denominator value, the value will be negative. So that is why delta S1 will be negative. Same way, let us find out the entropy change for subsystem 2. So for subsystem 2, you can identify that delta S2, same procedure. Now we are going from 2 to F, right? So let us write down dQ reversible by T. So 2 to F, right? So again, dq reversible is equal to m2 c2 delta t dt divided by t. M2 c2 will remain constant from the integral sign, so you will have integration of dt by t, and that will be nothing but natural log, right? So ln t, and you have limit 2 to f. So substitute that limit, you will have tf by t2. Again, let me remind you that you have to take the temperature in Kelvin. That is why capital T will represent the temperature in Kelvin, small t will represent the temperature in Celsius. So you can write M2C2 ln Tf plus 273 divided by T2 plus 273. Right? Now this value will be positive because Tf will be higher than T2. That we know. Right? And this value will be positive such that the value of delta S2 will be higher or greater than the value of delta S1. So the total value of the universe will be positive. Right? So that is how the mixing of two fluids can be analyzed from the perspective of entropy change or entropy missing. Today we are going to discuss about entropy change for non-flow processes. So let us start with the discussion. Here, non-flow processes, the very first process will be constant volume process. So constant volume process, that you are very well familiar with the process, right? So we know that if constant volume process is there, obviously it will be applicable for ideal gas. So Q is equal to mCv delta T, that is T2 minus T1. So for infinitesimal small change, we can write dQ is equal to mCv delta T, that is dT, right? Now entropy change can be written as dS is equal to mCv dT divided by T, right? Because we know that dS is equal to dQ by T and dQ is equal to mCv dT. So mCv dT divided by T, right? So if we will integrate this term between 1 and 2, then we can write the entropy change as S2 minus S1 is equal to mCv ln T2 divided by T. Okay. Further, let us take the next procedure. So this was the process, that is constant volume process, and for that constant volume process, you can write the entropy change as mCv ln T2 by T. Okay. Now, same way, constant pressure process, you can also evaluate that by yourself. So for constant pressure process, simple, Q is equal to mCp T2 minus T1, right? So for infinitesimal small change, we can write dQ is equal to mCp dT, right? So here dQ is equal to mCp dT, and we know that dS is equal to dQ divided by T. So in place of dQ, we can write mCp dT divided by T, right? So mCp will be taken as common. Integration of dT by T will give you natural log. So we will have the entropy change S2 minus S1 as ln mCp ln T2 divided by T1, right? So that is the entropy change for constant pressure process. Next is constant temperature process. Now for constant temperature process, students, recall the first law. According to that, dQ is equal to dU plus dW. Now we know that if the temperature is constant, then internal energy change, that is dU, will be equivalent to zero. So if dU is equal to zero, then you can write dQ is equivalent to dW. And we know that dW is nothing but pdV work. So that is why we can write dW is equal to pdV. Right? Here, dS, that is entropy change, integration of entropy change is equal to nothing but dQ by T. So instead of dQ, we can write pdV divided by T. Now we know that for ideal gas, we can write the ideal gas equation as PV is equal to mRT. So here we have P by T. So what we can write? We can write P by T is equivalent to mR by V. Right? So we can write mR by V. So we will substitute the value in the equation of entropy change. So dS will be equivalent to mR. Now mR will be taken as constant from the integration sign. So integration of dV divided by V. And dV by V is nothing but integration is natural log. So we can write down the equation of entropy change for constant temperature process as S2 minus S1 is equal to mR ln V2 by V1. Okay, so that is how you can write down the equation. Okay, now next change is adiabatic process. Very well aware to you guys, right? So for adiabatic process, you can simply write, and you know that the adiabatic process will not have any heat transfer. So dQ will be equivalent to zero. And if it is reversible process, then dQ reversible will be equivalent to zero. So now we know that entropy change dS is equal to what? dq reversible by T. So if dq reversible is 0, that means entropy change ds is equal to 0 for that reversible process. Then entropy will be constant. So for adiabatic process, the entropy change will be 0 and entropy will be constant. Further, polytropic process. So for polytropic process, simple, we can also start from the first law of thermodynamics. So dq is equal to du plus dw. Again, du is equal to what? Simple cv into dt, mcv dt, and dw is equal to what? Pdv, right? So here mcv dt plus pdv, that is equivalent to dq. Now we know that entropy change ds is equal to what? Integration of dq divided by T, wherein we will substitute the value of dq. So we will get mcv dt divided by T plus pdv divided by T. Now mcv from the first term will be taken as common. So integration of dt divided by T plus P by T. Now instead of P by T, what we can write? MR by V according to the ideal gas equation. So MR by V, from that MR will be taken as constant from the integration sign. So from integration, what we will get? dV by V, right? We will have to integrate dV by V. Okay, so now this whole equation, I am reading it again. dS is equal to mCV integration dT by T plus MR dV by V, right? I hope you can see that on the screen. Now, the total entropy change will be equal to what? S2 minus S1 is equal to mCV ln T2 divided by T1 plus MR ln V2 divided by V1. So that is how you can write down the entropy change for polytropic process. Okay, so these were all the non-flow processes, and you can write down the entropy change for this kind of processes. Okay, so today we are going to keep up to this point. Thank you.